from the Groove Lounge in beautiful downtown Key West. Tonight we have special guests Deb Hudson, Peter Anderson, Trinidad Joe, Adrienne, Ron Meridian, and Richie Ciavalino, the comedy team, the Improbables, Joanie Sullivan, Petra Sobek, Gina Maserati, Gigi Varnum, and now here's your host, Larry Smith, and co-host, Jenna Stauffer.
Take it away, Larry. Take it away.
Whoa. I got
screamed.
Like,
that was a good scream.
I got excited.
Right there.
I heard the damn, what is that thing? The Concord.
Conch shell. Yeah. you screamed like someone was hurting you, Larry.
And how about Island Alex? What an announcer.
Did he announce his name?
I don't even know because I got all whacked out from the conch shell.
Larry threw a very big fit last week because when Island Alex was giving the introduction, he said, "And presenting Island Alex." And it's not a big deal. He had to introduce himself, so I don't understand.
But anyway.
Anyways, Island Alex, that was our announcer.
And that was Peter Anderson, who we have on later. He's the president of the whole world, I think.
How do you think he can do that? Make that noise out of it. Can anyone do that, or is it just Peter Anderson's touch?
I think some people are good at it, and some people aren't. It takes a skill. We'll ask him about it.
Okay. We'll ask him about the skill of blowing in a conch shell.
Yeah.
Right?
And how was your week?
Was my week? It's been good. It's middle of the week, Wednesday. It's been going okay.
Do you know
okay.
what I did last Saturday?
What did you do last Saturday?
Anything I wanted. I had Saturday night off.
Okay.
So I went golfing in the day. I shot 103 because I didn't care. I drank and I
103 is not very good, Larry.
I shot 86 today.
Okay, 86. But, I would brag about that.
Well, that's more about what I am, but I shot 103 with my friend Tino. And my friend Mark, and we went to the American Legion after that.
And what happened at the Legion?
We had fun, and I said a swear word, and I almost got kicked out of the American Legion.
Larry Smith, say a swear word. Never.
I did my best Larry Smith to get myself back in, and now me and the bartender are the best of friends.
Okay, so, okay, anyway. good.
And then I went out that night, and I saw Dave Boodle play music at Ilona's. I've never been, you know, Ilona's?
Mm-hmm.
It's on Apple Ruth. Lane, and I just had a great night.
Good.
And then
good.
I didn't like Sunday because I was hungover.
Okay, well, that's what happens when you drink too much, Larry. That's what happens. All right, our show tonight. Deb Hudson is our showcase musical guest. She has a beautiful voice. You are actually a huge fan of Deb Hudson, and you're not a big country fan, are you? In general?
You know what? I like all kinds of music.
But you like Deb Hudson.
Country is not something that I choose to listen to. However, I've been in many country bands. I played the Philadelphia Folk Festival with Eric Anderson, who is like folk country music. And I lived in Woodstock and played with many folk and country musicians. You know what? Like Duke Ellington said, two types of music.
Okay.
Good music and bad music.
Okay.
You know? And sometimes I even like the bad music. So it's I don't know what it is that emotionally.
So you just called country bad music?
No, I did not call country bad music. I said that Duke Ellington was trying to explain that if somebody said to him, "Do you like country music?" He said, "There's only two types of music: good music and bad music. And there's good music in country music, and there's bad music in country music. Where there's good music in jazz music and bad music in jazz music." What I'm saying is,
sometimes
I like the bad music even.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay,
it's just whatever emotionally affects me. And let me tell you, sincerely and without saying this to be a is it sycophant or psychophant? I don't
psychophan.
Know.
Psychophan. I don't know. Sycophan.
What,
I don't.
Sycophant. Yeah.
Sycophant.
Yeah.
I don't even know what you're talking about. I'm just calling you a sycophant or a psycho.
I'm not doing this just to blow smoke up Deb Hudson's
butt.
Yeah, how do you even say
skirt, but
you know what?
Okay, but let's bring Deb Hudson up. Deb Hudson, please come up here.
What I wanted to say is I'm a fan of Deb Hudson.
Okay.
Yeah, after having a... Deb, come on up here.
Deb, I'm sorry. He started talking about your skirt, your behind. How are you, Deb Hudson?
I'm
singer,
great.
Vocalist, songwriter. This woman, she can do it all.
I'm trying to give you a compliment. is it working? I don't know.
That was another left-handed one you... throughout there, but I liked it.
But after having gotten to know Deb this weekend because I rehearsed her songs, I'm really quite a fan. So
okay,
I think you're a great songwriter.
Thank you so much.
And your songs tonight, they are all your originals. Mm-hmm. What inspired you to be a songwriter, Deb?
I grew up in North Carolina, and I sang in Raleigh for years and years, and I started writing songs at 12 and was doing weddings and coffee houses and things like that when I was a kid. And when I moved to Nashville in my late 20s, one of the first people that I met there was Harlan Howard, who wrote I Fall to Pieces. And he became my mentor. And then I met Don Everly, Guy Clark, John Prine, Roger Cook, on and on. And
wow.
Was just so inspired being able to hang out with these guys and learn things. And Harlan told me, I'd gone there to sing. And Harlan said, no, he says, you really have to write too. And I was a writer. I just, you know, had to evolve.
When did you start writing songs? What age?
12.
Okay. She said that already. Did you miss it?
I wasn't listening.
I know. Surprise, surprise.
Typical man.
And how many songs have you written, do you think, in your career?
Oh, 200-300?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Very impressive.
When you write a song, how long does it take you to write a song, generally?
Usually they used to come pretty quickly when I actually wrote a lot. My creative juices haven't been flowing as they were in Nashville. That was 20 years ago. So they come a lot slower now. But there were times when you would just have to be at, I worked at MTM. I was a writer there for a while. And you have to go in for a 10 o'clock session with somebody you don't know and just sit down and write a song.
Oh,
so
wow.
Back
yeah.
then, though, it was pretty easy. Mm-hmm. And
when's the last time you wrote a song?
Well, I've started 100 of them lately.
Okay, all right, well, very good.
Well, I have a question. You said you grew up in Raleigh, moved to Nashville. How are we so lucky to have you here in Key West?
When the publishing company I was writing for folded, that was Mary Tyler Moore's publishing company, and also I was dating a songwriter at the time, and we broke up, and those two things happening simultaneously, I said, I'm just going to go somewhere, and came here on a hiatus and just fell in love with it, and stayed.
Here you are.
I actually moved away and moved back. It took
oh,
me
really?
A long time
well, what,
to get back.
What then made you come back?
A man.
A man? Oh, yeah. A man. They always do it, darn it.
Now, you're performing currently with Bill Blue.
Yes, I sing with Bill Blue, and we rock 'em, sock 'em, blues rock.
What did you do this weekend?
We went and played the River Hawk Festival up above Tampa. And it camped out in 36 degrees. That was fun. And played Friday and Saturday night there, and it was a lot of fun.
What is the first song you're going to perform for us tonight?
This song I wrote about guitar players from a woman's perspective, being okay. in a relationship with a guitar player.
Mm-hmm. Wait, was it a good relationship or a bad relationship? Or are we going to find out in the song?
You're going to find out in the song.
I jumped the gun, sorry.
Yeah, it's called Guitar Man.
All right, take
this
it away.
This is Kim Wroble joining us on bass.
I've learned a thing or two about making plans. You can't depend on a guitar man. Thinking about the future doesn't make no sense. You gotta live your life in the present tense. He's got a lot of friends that he meets downtown. They make a lot of noise but nothing comes down. Women like me lead a lonesome life. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Oh, you never know when he'll up and go. He can't stay still cause he's on a roll. And things like money never cross his mind. Oh, what can you do with a roving kind? Out all night and he sleeps all day. Guitar man will play his life away. Women like me lead a lonesome life. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Well, I'm packing my bags, I'm out of here. Don't know much, but one thing's clear. Guitar man, I'm leaving you behind. Go find your own dream, honey, I've got mine. My wheels are rolling, I'm glad to be leaving that man far behind me. Saying goodbye to the lonesome life. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. The wheels are rolling, I'm glad to be leaving to that man far behind me. Say goodbye to that lonesome life. Guitar man, you don't need a wife. Guitar man, you never need a wife. Go on away from your guitar man.
Deb Hudson!
Stay away from those guitar men. We will be back with more Deb Hudson. And coming up, we have the Contrapuntland's very own Peter Anderson. Stay with us.
The sound sounds fucked up, man. Oh, sorry, guys. Yeah. Well, because we didn't start at 9, my times are all screwed up now here. Don't worry about it. When did we start? Because our times are all fucked up.
I know, they're going to be messed up.
Welcome back.
Welcome
That's Jenna.
Back, everyone.
You know what?
All I did was two beats, Larry. That was pretty pathetic.
Do you know what I think that do you write poetry or prose or anything?
Yes, I write a lot of poetry. No, I do not write poetry. I wish that I could. Roses are red, violets are blue.
Okay, but you...
No one ever smelled just like you.
You took 8 years of piano lessons, right?
8 years of piano.
Okay.
That's right.
Do you know what I'm gonna have you write the lyrics to a theme song to the Larry and Jenna show. And that's going to... The next thing, you're going to move to Nashville and become a country western songwriter like Deb Hudson and the whole...
She was great. She was great. And
how do you like Deb Hudson's songwriting, man?
Very, very
I'm telling
good.
You, she's great.
And she has... been able to perform and songwrite with so many impressive artists. That's, you know.
She's great, yeah.
That's very impressive to me.
I love her songs. They're very concise. They're very easy to swallow. They just go down very easy. Mm-hmm. I like them.
Yeah, you saved yourself from talking too badly about country, I feel like, earlier.
But you know, if that came across like that you're getting the wrong impression.
Oh, I am?
Yeah,
okay,
yes, you
sorry.
Are. Yeah,
no. Maybe I'm just the one. You know, I guess I don't normally like country that much, but I like her, so. Anyways.
I like people that touch me, and it doesn't matter.
Touch you.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter what genre.
It
doesn't matter what the genre is.
Okay.
It could be country, it could be folk, it could be Egyptian, it could be...
Egyptian.
It could be klezmer music, it could
Egyptian,
be polkas,
okay.
It could be anything.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
It either touches me or doesn't. And Deb Hudson touches
you.
Yeah,
she touches
does.
You. And okay. So. All right, let's bring up our next guest, Peter Anderson. Sir Peter Anderson, excuse me, the Conch Republic's
the
very
guy,
own.
He's the guy who blew the conch shell.
Stud muffin right there.
Give us another little toot on there, will you, Peter?
Another toot.
Thank Thank you. Grab that mic and tell us how it is that you're able to even grab that microphone right there. And tell us
how you can do that so
and
beautifully,
make sure
Peter.
That it switches up. There you go.
Now it's working. Yeah, there we go. You just pucker up and blow, Larry.
Pucker up and blow, Larry.
No, actually, you've got to buzz your lips. You've got to make your lips sort of go. There's a lot of spit involved. It's not pretty.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, yeah.
The Conch Republic, 1982.
Yes.
Give us a bit of a history, will you?
Well, what happened out there in 1982, the United States Border Patrol decided they were going to shut down the Florida Keys with a border checkpoint right where Cardstown Road and US 1 came together. They were stopping everybody coming out of the Keys, making them prove citizenship. They claimed to be searching for illegal aliens, but residents and visitors wondered what aliens could be hiding in their glove boxes and under their front seats. And the result was an 18-mile traffic jam. So, to make a long story short, David Paul Horan, an attorney in town who had argued Mel Fisher's treasure case to the Supreme Court, tried to get the government enjoined in federal court in Miami from treating us like a foreign country. And essentially, the judge refused to do so. So when the mayor walked down the steps, Dennis Wardlow walked down the steps of the federal courthouse in Miami, the assembled world press, because this had become a huge story. You could get into the Keys, but you couldn't get back out. The assembled world press said, Mr. Mayor, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? He said, I'm going to go home and secede from the Union. Well, with a statement like that, they all followed him back down to Key West for the next day on the back of a flatbed truck. He seceded Key West from the United States, proclaiming the Conch Republic. He then declared war on the United States, and Josie Balventine, our first Minister of Defense, went out and hit a real U.S. admiral in uniform about the head and shoulders with stale Cuban bread. Stale bread, by the way, remains our weapon of choice for dealing with federalist or other repressive forces. And over a couple of... thank you. Who can hate a nation that fights with bread? And in fact, over a few cocktails a while ago, we figured out we are, in fact, the best-armed country in the world. If you think about it, everywhere bread is baked, the Conch Republic has a weapons factory.
There you go.
Anyway, he surrendered immediately, demanding $1 billion in foreign aid. Almost 29 years later, we're still waiting for the foreign aid. But today we stand proudly as the world's first fifth world nation, a sovereign state of mind that seeks only to bring more humor, simple human warmth, and respect to a world we find, frankly, in sore need of all three. And we have a stated foreign policy, which is the mitigation of world tension through the exercise of humor, and stand proudly as the people who seceded where others failed.
That is your motto. I love it. And this is the Secretary General of the Conch Republic. At your service. That's right. At your service, who can make you your very own passport.
That's correct. We do have passports for the Conch Republic, and you can go to our website shamelessly, www.conchrepublic.com. That's conchrepublic.com. And become a citizen of the Conch Republic because we accept citizens of like mind wherever and whenever they shall apply.
And Larry? You would
even
accept?
Larry. Okay. Well, no, Larry is...
People have actually traveled the world on those passports.
Yeah, this man right here.
Well, we don't represent them that way, of course. But that said, they have saved people's lives in third world countries. Americano no, Republica de la Cancha. And Bud Navarro wound up getting filled with shots of tequila instead of shots from the Kalashnikov. He was very happy. So
what a lucky man, right?
Yeah.
Bobby Green just told his story about going to Germany on that
Well,
passport.
He got into Germany. They stand. Bobby didn't have a passport. We were going to Germany for the opening of our consulate in Innsbruck, Austria. And he didn't have a passport. So we made him one. And off we go to Germany. Well, they stamped him right in. But when he got ready to go home, the Lufthansa wouldn't fly him. They said, we're not flying you on that path. He said, but you flew me over here.
Right.
So Bobby wound up having to get a passport. And I told him to bring his birth certificate and his voter's card and driver's license. And
tell
so
us
he
a
was
little
able
bit. I know that Bobby is something in the Conch Republic.
Bobby is our flag ambassador. Bobby Green caused many years ago a Conch Republic flag to be made that was 12 feet by 18 feet.
Oh, my goodness.
Really big flag.
Okay, and you guys, okay, I said you're the Secretary General. Bobby has this position. Do you guys have, like, a secret handshake or a certain thing
no,
you do?
No, but we do have an ultra-secret intelligence contingent
called
Intercom.
You have an ultra-secret
contingent.
Tingent.
Contingent.
Okay, contingent.
Yes, ultra-secret contingent called Intercom.
Okay.
And you have no need to know.
I don't get to know. Come on. on, Peter.
Well, nope. Seriously, there's national security issues.
Okay, sorry.
Who else are some of the people that are the government of the Conch Republic?
Well, we do have a duly elected head of government. Our prime minister is the duly elected mayor of the city of Key West at any given time.
Okay.
And right now, that is the Honorable Craig Gates. Let's hear it for Craig Gates.
Yeah. Woo! The mayor.
And he's a great prime minister for the Conch Republic. He loves the Conch Republic, and I've enjoyed working with him. Captain Tony was our Prime Minister Emeritus, and the guy had appointed me as the Conch Republic's first Secretary General in the year of our Lord, 1990.
Wow. And Peter, how long do you plan on being in your position and being involved with all of this?
Well, the Conch Republic is the world's first functioning meritocracy. If you see a job that needs doing, go out, do it well. People recognize you, they listen to you, you have position. If you ever stop doing it or stop doing it well in a meritocracy, people quit listening to you and the position. Radical snow skiers whose motto is you fall, you die, understand meritocracy very well. So I'll be Secretary General of the Conch Republic as long as I'm, one, drawing breath.
Okay.
Here on the green side
one
of the
drawing
dirt.
Drawing breath, okay.
And two, don't screw up so badly that people quit listening to me.
Okay, well, let's hope you don't do that. Thank you so much,
do me a favor.
Peter.
Thank you very much. Blow that conch as you go out.
Blow it one more time.
Peter Anderson,
wonderful.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Peter.
Deb Hudson, get
pleasure.
Up here. Kim Wroble.
Deb, please come on up here. And Kim, take us into break. We will be right back after this with another Deb Hudson song, Trinidad Joe, and songwriter Adrienne.
I guess we're waiting.
Oh, okay.
You can go ahead.
He was just a poor man with stars in his eyes. Had a little woman that he cherished like a prize. Lived his life just to see her smile. They just don't make him like that anymore. No, they don't make him like that anymore. My mama was just a girl when this man came along. She believed in him and he could do no wrong. She lived her life just to see him smile. They just don't make him like that anymore. No, they don't make him like that anymore. Now here I am, the product of this loving pair. I wonder if I'll ever find the kind of love they shared. Daddy died, I watched my mama walk the floor. She says, they just don't make 'em like that anymore. He was just a poor man with stars in his eyes. Had a little woman that he cherished like a prize. He lived his life just to see her smile. They just don't make him like that anymore. No, they don't make him like that anymore. No, they don't make like that anymore. No, they don't make 'em like that anymore.
Deb Hudson, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Deb. We'll be back with Adrienne. Ron Maranian. sound great, man. No, we didn't know what was going on. Jenna thought we were going to break.
No, we didn't. Oh. Wait, what do you mean? I thought the other one. Yeah, we can call you up if she has a camera. If you can tell her to send her.
Yeah, you. Yeah. We're gonna do 2 minutes of stuff. Yeah. I thought you said we were going to break.
I said she was going
to
break.
Oh, all right, okay, all right. Hey, Peter. Great job. Well, all right.
Thank you, Larry.
Yeah, thanks, man. Did you have fun? All right, good.
You put some emotion in that scatting.
Yeah, I'm starting to feel like I'm waking up or something now.
Thank goodness you're waking up, Larry. You're waking up. maybe it was Deb Hudson that did it to you, or maybe it was
Hudson mesmerized
the blowing in the conch shell.
You know what? It was the conch shell, man. It put me in
it
that
just,
like weird.
Awakened your senses.
You put me in a, like a weird thing, like man.
I have a feeling that you're gonna go find a conch shell and you're gonna <I'm> take gonna... lessons and practice blowing in this conch shell, aren't you?
I'm gonna try to get to be somebody in the Conch Republic.
I know.
Something.
I don't know if you're allowed, Larry.
Oh yeah.
Well, maybe. I think that the beret would let you be allowed in the Congress.
I could be the French guy.
Yeah. Wait, can I just tell everyone? I'm sorry. I just have to tell a little secret of Larry. I get a phone call tonight right before the show, and he says, Jenna, what are you wearing tonight? Because I don't have Christine here. I need help. I need wardrobe
help. I need somebody to dress me.
Well, Larry, you look very, very sharp. So.
You like it? Yeah, thank you.
This man, doesn't he look great? You look great.
I didn't know whether to wear the white beret or the blue beret.
Well, you've made a good choice.
I went blue, blue, white, white.
And you know who I think is a very big fan of you is Deb Hudson. Let's bring her back up again. I want to hear another song.
Kim Wroble. By the way, that's Kim Wroble on bass.
He's great.
Playing
I
with
love
us.
Having these two stallions. Do you like how I just called you a stallion?
Where the hell did he go now?
Kim
Wroble.
All right, Deb, you are going to be
singing. Is there a bass player in the house? Here he comes with his cowboy hat on.
Oh, here he comes. My side of town, correct?
Yes, and I have to mention Danny Parks on this song. Danny played fiddle with Mel Tillis. He played with Dickie Betts on guitar. He's a wonderful session musician in Nashville, and he co-wrote this song with me, so I have to give him credit on this one, too.
Okay.
You left your steak in Chablis for burgers and beer. You've come a long, long way to be with me here. You left your own party to hurry on down, 'cause you always have a big time on my side of town. Let's turn up the jukebox, I'll loosen your tie, and order us a cold one, your throat must be dry. We'll slow dance to Haggard and we'll Cotton Eye Joe. We'll make our own party till you have to go. You've been all around the world, and I'm just a simple country girl. No one understands why you keep coming around, but you always have fun on my side of town.
Great fun.
think much of me. Don't have a nice car or a rich family. They look down their noses every time you come back. But we don't care what they think on their side of the tracks. You've been all around the world, and I'm just a simple country girl. No one understands why you keep coming around, but you always have fun on my side of town. You've been all around the world, and I'm just a simple country girl. No one understands why you keep coming around, but you always have fun on my side of town. Yeah, you always have fun on my side of town.
Deb Hudson, ladies
beautiful,
and gentlemen.
Beautiful song. I
thank
love
y'all.
It. Thank you,
y'all.
Deb. We still have one more song from her. And coming up right now, Trinidad Joe, get up here. I want to hear some old school poetry. Oh, look at that bandana, Trinidad Joe.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I love it.
Yes.
Take it away already, Trinidad Joe.
I was surprised for you. I'm also Sir Lancelot of the Conquered Republic.
Sir Lancelot.
Sir Lancelot. That's
always,
my real name.
You always surprise
me. Man, what the hell do you have on your head, son?
Hey. It looks good. It looks good. What do you have for us?
From Cancun. This poem is called I've Got Nothing On But The Radio. My baby left home this morning, but half past dawn. When I said, honey, where you going? She just said, I won't be going long. I don't know where she went or how long she had to go. So I'm just lying here with nothing on but the radio. Then I heard a car drove up, so I ran and opened the door. I didn't see her, but guess what a neighbor saw? Later on, it was way past noon. Heck, it was late afternoon. Baby, please come back. Please come back soon. Now it's dawn again, and you still didn't show. But I'm still lying right here with nothing on but the radio.
Watch out.
Thank you.
Thank
Trinidad Joe, baby.
Always a pleasure. Always a pleasure.
Thank you.
Love the bandana, by the way. And Adrienne, will you please come on up here so we can close out?
Yeah, we're going to. Next week, our featured musical guest is Adrienne.
So
and of course, Gigi.
And you are going to want both of these girls, more of them, after you hear this.
Yes.
Take it away, you Adrienne, beautiful ladies. Adrienne and Gigi, I'm sorry, I interrupted you, Larry.
Adrienne, Gigi, and I have been co-writing songs for the last year, and this is one of them. Gigi Varnum, Adrienne Zoladink. Zoladink? Zoladink.
It's just Adrienne. Leave that last name out. She's wondering when he might come a knocking. He's afraid of the clouds. It's just a covering the sun, knowing his reputation. It's a mad situation, a grim premonition. She remembers the time he came a raging. Saw the storm in the sky, no explaining to come. And she leered gray and ghostly, but what she feared mostly was a grim premonition. Yeah. of his eyes. Every day she is stronger. Her life is no longer a grim premonition. Stronger. Life is no longer a grim premonition. Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you, Adrienne, Gigi, Larry, and Kim. Be right back.
Thank you, guys. Gigi and Adrienne. Yeah, you got Montego Bay. And Al, you want to sing? Hey, why don't you play for Alex? Mrs. Evett. Yeah. And then. Is Ron up?
Yeah.
Let set him up, man. Oh, you guys, are they going to be up here now?
Yeah, we're already on, Larry.
We're on.
We're on. You can
when did this happen?
Chatting if you want to.
I didn't know that. That's yeah. That's when you see that when you go on and the sportscaster is picking their nose or something. Did something like that ever happen to you?
No, it does not happen to me because I do not pick my nose. No,
I didn't mean that.
Larry,
not that necessarily, but did you ever get caught? Like I just got caught?
I mean, I'm sure I made some mistakes. I don't know. I can't think right now off the top of my head.
Okay. All right. So let's get right.
I'm pretty cautious. I refrain from using the F word like you don't do. That's
I'm getting better, though. I'm getting better. I only use
F word.
Did I use it
say
tonight?
Say that. Don't say the word.
Did I say it tonight?
I think you made a... Okay. Maybe once, twice, three times, four times.
I apologize then if I did. It's not my intention.
Not your intentions. All right. Okay.
Anyway, hey, look, Richie Ciavalino's here, man.
And Ron Meridian, the Armenian comedian, with another fabulous tie. He is known for his ties. What is this one tonight, Ron?
It's the Chrysler Building in New York.
My favorite building in the world. Leave it to you.
If you ever want to get me a present, buy me this building. That would be awesome.
The Chrysler Building.
Well, do your shtick, man. This is Ron Moranian and Richie Ciavalino. Go ahead, Ron.
You too.
Okay. We're gonna do a poem written by a guy named Mark Spiegel who I went to high school with. There you go. And this is called Fofo the Bow. I should tell you in case I can't get through it. Fofo the Bow stands for food for the body, and this is about a king who ran a country that would get along really well with the conquered republic. So this is the story of Fofo the Bow. Once upon a time, in a land long ago, lived a king whose name was Fofo the Bow. Now, Fofo the Bow was a very wise king. He just sat on his throne, and he didn't do a thing but sing. He sang red notes, and he sang them green. He sang the wildest colors that you ever have seen. He sang rainbows around the moon and back. He sang the sun yellow and the nighttime black. In fact, he sang so much when he was 10 years old, he sang all the streets of his kingdom to gold. Now, a king who can sing in such a colorful way isn't the kind of king you'd meet every day, and the people of the land all love their king. Came from miles around just to watch him sing. From 9 in the morning till 2:45, they gathered underneath the king's balcony where Fofo the Bow would sit and sing down to the millions of people on the palace ground. He showered them with yellow notes and green notes, blue, chartreuse, purple, and vermilion, too. He had pink notes, gray notes, orange, and black, and every note he showered down was sharp as a tack with a rhythm that the king would only call jazz, a real gone rootin' tootin' razzmatazz, and the people really dug it, because when it was cold, Fofo the Bow sang and heated their soul. In the summertime when the sun was hot, a cool, nice rhythm was the song they got. They laughed at the storm clouds because it was plain. Fofo the Bow's notes dried up the rain. The little king's song could harvest a crop, paint a church steeple, and ring dry a mop. Fofo the Bow's rhythm never would end. Man, he'd sing all his colors and he'd sing them again. But then, in the bowels of the palace from early to late, pacing back and forth were the great men of state. The reason these men were walking around so, they were very unhappy with Fofo the Bow. You see, all of the lands surrounding this one had kings working very hard to get things done. Signing papers, making speeches, accepting and rejecting the people's beseeches. But all they had was a silly old king who woke up in the morning just so he could sing. Nothing to do, they just paced all the day while they couldn't give advice to the king in any way. Because every single time they tried to complain, Fofo the Bow's notes dried up the rain. The little king's song could harvest a crop, paint a church steeple, and ring dry a mop. Fofo the Bow's rhythm never would end, but he'd sing every color, then he'd sing them again. But then, his advisors cried, Fofo the Bow, there's lots more that you need to do. Fofo the Bow said, ah, yes, I do agree. I'll have to take a look, it seems to me. Out from the palace to the countryside, Fofo the Bow looking far and wide. Now, most of the land he'd come to know was farmland where the people would grow fruits and vegetables to harvest in the fall. Fofo the Bow walked around through it all. He saw a deep purple eggplant, bright yellow corn, ripe tomatoes and pumpkins born. Oranges are on the trees. There was cauliflower, broccoli, and lots of sweet peas. Fields of potatoes and green string beans. Fofo the Bow said, I see what you mean. There's much more to do, and now that I've been looking, I'll get back to the palace and I'll get into cooking. All his advisors looked around in dismay. The king danced to the palace and he sang all the way. Singing them red notes, the blue and the white, he went down in the kitchen, started cooking that night, making soups, making salads, making vegetable stew, fruit compote before the night was through. Fofo the Bow's rhythm naturally shook, man. He never had to read even a single cookbook. Just taking a vegetable or fruit with a song, he'd sing a hot tune, and before very long, he cooked eggplant parmesan and lemon pie, sauerkraut, Munster on toasted rye, brown rice, white rice, fried and plain, spinach lasagna, and quiche Lorraine. Insane. That's what his advisors said he was, and the kingdom would fall to pieces because there still wasn't anything for them to advise. They moaned and they groaned about the kingdom's demise, but there wasn't anything that they could do because the people all loved the king through and through. Fofo the Bow on his balcony, singing and giving his food away free, but as he sang his rhythms, red, white, and blue, from the corner of the kingdom came the horrible news. An army was marching from the country next door. Fofo the Bow found himself in a war. What's more, his advisors said if reports were right, the army would reach the king's palace at night. Yes, Fofo the Bow did agree. We have a lot of work to do, it seems to me. At last, his advisors were smiling with joy, advising the king like a brand new toy. Fofo the Bow just nodded and took his advisors to the kitchen, and he started to cook. But his advisors cried, King, we're at war. Fofo the Bow cooked like never before. Should we call out the troops? Every man able, the king replied, set the banquet table. As the army's attack began to begin, the king opened the doors and he let them all in to the banquet hall. It was such a surprise to see the banquet table in front of their eyes, piled high with food beyond imagination. The enemy army stood in fascination. And Fofo the Bow started singing his song, the rainbow of colors. And before long, very long, war was forgotten and the army sat down in the greatest feast in the world to be found. Now with everybody happy, I want you to know that's the story and the glory of Fofo the Bow.
Good job, you two! Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Ron Moranian, the Armenian comedian. comedian and Richie on the
Richie
drum.
Ciavalino.
Let's bring up the Improbables right now. Come on up, you guys.
How do you like that? Ron Moranian, ladies and gentlemen. The Improbables.
Richie and Richie, both of them. Fabulous. Fabulous. Improbables, take it away.
Take that stand away, will you, Mary? Thank you.
So Danielle and I are going to have a conversation this evening. And for any of our hard of hearing audience members out there, Nikki is going to mime our conversation for you.
I'm a little bit forgetful sometimes. So, you know, if I happen to go, she's going to actually read my mind.
Mm-hmm.
So I was actually walking down Duval Street the other day, and I saw one of those people walking with the thing on their head.
A monkey.
Oh, right. It was a monkey on their heads, but I thought it was the parrot head days, so I was really, really confused.
Yeah.
So, and that person, they were just doing this little, what do you call it, those little things?
Hopscotch dance.
Yes, exactly. That's what they were doing, the hopscotch dance.
Mm-hmm.
And that even confused me more because I'm from Canada and, you know, I'm very easily confused.
Yeah. Oh, boy. I really hate it when that happens. Talking of those parrot heads, like, why do they all wear those things around their necks? Those
big, long bandanas?
Those big, long bandanas around their necks. I never really got that. I thought that was like the biker thing. But, you know, so the other day, a whole contour train of those parrot heads with the monkeys on their heads and the long bandanas around their necks went by me. And they were all yelling and screaming, and they were throwing those conch shells at me. And I was like ducking from those conch shells, and the monkeys were jumping all over the place, and the conch tour driver was telling about stuff that didn't really happen on the island. And then that thing jumped out at me. That
huge gorilla.
That huge gorilla. God, I hate it when that happens.
I know. I go around the corner and I see those huge gorillas all the time here in Key West. And it freaks me out, okay?
Oh,
it
God.
Really, really does.
And they're always asking for money to buy beer at Circle K.
Right. Being from Canada, I'm only used to those things with the big, you know, what are they called? Those
antennas.
Yeah, the moose with the antennas.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's why I'm so confused living here in Key West.
I know. I hate it when that happens. With the Improbables, 8 o'clock Saturday night here at the Bottle Cap.
Thank you.
The Improbables, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, thank you. We'll be right back after this break. We have Alex and the Sassy Alex set. Deborah for another song, so stay with us.
Montego Bay before him, and then him, yeah. And then be prepared to come right back up right at the end of his, okay? To right up.
You're great. Sorry, I just called you Deborah. I don't know
if I'm just saying Deborah. Petra. Are you ready? Are you ready to ask the question?
Right,
Where is she?
Carolyn.
Yeah.
We'll call you up.
Yeah. Joanie's out.
30 seconds.
Hey, Kim. Get.
We'll call you. We're not going to talk long. Actually, you just stand up there. Just you.
Okay, we'll call you.
I didn't hear what you said.
No, I don't even.
That was a little, sorry, that was a little Halloween-y.
Yeah, I got mixed up.
I know.
Hey, the Improbables were great.
They were. They How were about, great. And Ron Moranian, the Armenian comedian. I just love saying that name.
Yeah, and
Richie on the drums.
How did could you ever remember that many words to a poem?
No, I don't know how he did it. I was thinking about that while he was doing it to the beat.
And he didn't write it. His schoolmate wrote it or something.
Very impressive. Yeah. Very impressive. But it was his tie. I think it's his ties that kind of bring out his creativity.
And I've always liked Richie Ciavalino. I don't spend enough time with him. I miss him. And
He misses you, Richie. So but spend anyway, some more time.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
Hey, you know what? Petra Sobek is in the house, and
Petra and Carolyn are both in the house. Well, and I think we need to bring both of them up right now because the bottle cap has something special.
Do you know
going
what I missed
Friday.
Tonight? Was what? Was our
what do you miss?
I missed Fred Covan.
Fred
Covan is in New York City, demanded to be there to testify from some psychological stuff.
So you're going to have to go loopy this week, Larry, because he couldn't answer your
need
questions.
When he's not here, I get far out.
Even farther
yes, yes,
out.
Yes, I get farther out. Thank
okay.
you.
These two lovely ladies right
Hello.
Up here.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Carolyn, Petra, tell us what's going on. You know.
Okay, so
weekend.
What's going on a bottle cup on
so
a Friday?
So what's going on with you?
I don't know. I have to wait for a Fred to answer.
You know what? Petra was on the golf course today, and you didn't seem yourself. You seemed out of sorts.
Well, you was in the same mood.
Was I in the mood? Too?
Yes. Yeah, actually,
when,
pretty
when
much.
When I saw you, you're generally so animated, but you seemed introspective today.
Yeah, my mind it was somewhere totally far away.
Well, what's
from
the matter?
I'm going to talk with a doctor.
Yeah, she needs Dr. Covan, and he's not
Fred
here.
Fred Covan's not here. Well,
let the women talk, Larry.
You guys go ahead and be yourselves over there.
Okay, what's going on here on a Friday evening for a happy hour?
Friday at the Bottle Caps. We like to donate our gratuities on Friday happy hour to nonprofits. Every week we choose different ones. Actually, they choose us. And this week, it's a very special one. If you can come by, it's a lot of help for the Special Olympics. There's athletes in Monroe County that would love to be in the Special Olympics, and they're in Florida. They're held in Orlando or Miami or somewhere out of town, but they have to get there. So Island Gym, Key West Island Gym, which is on White Street, every year they try to raise enough money so they can get the athletes from Monroe County the room and board and the transportation to get up to the Special Olympics. So this Friday, our gratuities will benefit the Special Olympics for Monroe County. And that's from 5 to 8 p.m.
Awesome.
Yeah,
awesome.
And thanks to all our staff. Thanks to everybody for coming every Wednesday night for Conk AM for this live show. I think it's really fun. We love having you. Carmel and I are really happy to have you here. And we're going to do that every Wednesday night. On Thursday, we have Dave Boodle tomorrow night. I don't know if you've heard Dave Boodle, but he's wonderful. He starts at 9 o'clock. And we always have DJs on the weekend, and we've got the Improbables Saturday night. But,
so a busy schedule, and hopefully everyone can come out again to the bottle.
Petra, would you ask
ladies.
Deb Hudson to come back up here? Petra?
We love Deb Hudson,
yes,
don't we?
Of course. Come on in.
Thank you, lovely ladies. Deb, take it away with Montego Bay.
Going up the mountain, gonna see my friend. He got a two-story hut and 13 children. And he grow the corn and he grow the bean. He got rows of ganja growing in between. Yeah, man, he said, it's okay, no problem, Montego Bay. Yeah, man, it's okay, no problem, Montego Bay. Montego Baby. Got him some wives, I think there are six. He
built them a mansion made of mud and sticks. Well, I slid down a hill in the pouring rain and got twisted around by a hurricane. Yeah, Monty said, it's okay, no problem, Montego Bay. Yeah, Monty, it's okay, no problem, Montego Bay. Fish head stew.
Yeah.
You eat the eyeballs too,
Monty. Yeah.
Now me, I come from a golden land. Got no money and I got no plan. They come up short, but I'm dreaming tall. I just go with the flow and I stay neutral. Yeah, man, it's okay, no problem, Montego Bay. 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 Montego Bay.
Deb Hudson, ladies
Beautiful.
And gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you, Deb. And now Alex and his sassy Alexettes, please come up on stage and grace us with your presence.
Missed the Saturday dance, heard they crowded the floor. Can't bear it without you, don't get around much anymore.
Thought I'd visit the club, couldn't fit through the door. They'd have asked me about you, don't get around much anymore.
Darling, I guess my mind's more at ease.
But nevertheless, why stir up memories?
Been invited on dates, might have gone, but what for?
Awfully different without you, don't get around much anymore.
Sing it, Alex.
Yeah. Without you, don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club,
you couldn't fit through the door.
You got it, baby. They'd have to ask me about you,
don't get around much anymore.
Darling, I guess my mind's more ready. But nevertheless, look at me.
He's such a sleep.
Invited on dates.
He's been invited.
Might have gone, but what for?
What? Without you, without you.
Don't get around much anymore. Baby, I'll get around. Don't get around much anymore.
Alex and Gina Maserati. Deb Hudson, everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for joining us. We will be back here next Wednesday at 9 p.m.
Welcome to the Montego Bay.
Come on up. It's okay. No problem, Montego Bay. It's okay.
Come on.
No problem, Montego Bay. It's okay. No problem, Montego Bay.
Play that conch shell, baby.
It's
play
okay.
It, Peter.
No problem, Montego Bay.
Blow it, baby.
It's okay. No problem, Montego Bay. Yeah, man. It's okay. No problem, Montego Bay. Yeah, man. It's okay. No problem.
Let's just hear the voice.
Yeah, man. It's okay. No problem, Montego Bay. Hey, man, it's okay. No problem, Montego Bay.
Peter Anderson, Deb Hudson, Alex Okinczyc,
Trinidad Joe,
Trinidad Joe,
Carolyn Sullivan. Gina Maserati, Kim Wroble,
Richie Ciavalino, Jenna Hudson,
the Armenian comedian, the Improbables, Larry.
Tico Bay. It's okay. It's okay. No problem. Let's hear the vocals.
It's Adrienne and Gigi. I forgot it would have some.
No problem. Tico Bay.
We'll be back next Wednesday with songwriter Adrienne. Thank you.
It's okay, no problem, Montego Bay.
Here we go.
No problem, Montego Bay.
Thank you. See you next week.
Yeah, man.